Okay, here we are again. We went over lathes, we went over tools, we went over products. So now we're gonna actually make something in this video. And we're going to make one of these, a saffron box. And it is a hollow container that people used to put saffron in, which is a food seasoning. And anyway, we're gonna make one of these and see how this goes. This happens to be a piece of silver maple, kind of tiger stripe silver maple. I had never bothered with silver maple, and then one time I got a log and I realized that some of the grain in silver maple is pretty spectacular. So that's what that is. So we're gonna make one of these. And this piece happened to be sassafras, but we'll see if we can make one of those. Here we go. Now you have to sand this part of the cup because you can't get at it again. But when I don't sand a lot. Let's just see what we've got here. Oh, it looks pretty good. Needs a little bit. Okay, we've got the lid almost finished. Thank you. Okay, and that would be too tight, so if you hammer that on, it'll split the lid. You have to get this exactly right. Now you can use calipers if you want, but I don't use calipers. There we go. Plastic glasses aren't good. Static electricity sticks to them. Okay, now let's turn a little knob on top of the... Now what you try to do, you try to keep all the forces, you don't go ramming in, you try to keep all the forces back so the lid doesn't pop off. Static,
huh?
Yeah. Static electricity. It's in the... Doesn't need a lot of sanding, but a little bit.
Okay.
Okay, so much for the lid. Every now and then you have to scrape a little bit. When I talk about scraping, that's just what I was doing there. It's just, I couldn't get in here with a skewer and go like this. Like I'd like to, but we'll call the lid pretty well finished, so we'll take the lid off.
I'm gonna stop.
Okay.
We made the lid. So you sharpened some of your tools there and there. Just, we took a break and you sharpened a couple tools.
We sharpened tools and here's the lid. So now we're gonna make the rest of the...
Okay. So you got a hollow out the inside, which yep. You were saying a minute ago is a pain in the butt.
It is.
Okay.
And if you don't have good sound, you know, you can hear when the wood's get when it's getting thin. Before we do the inside, let's do a little bit on the outside so we get a rough idea of where we're headed. I like to rough the outside off a little bit. Just rough out the shape on the outside so you know how much to take out on the inside. So you can take a round nose or a gouge. I'm going to use a gouge. Just going to rough out. That's roughly the shape. I'll finish it with a skew. But let's do this right now. Let's do a little more to this. Now, you don't want to get it too thin down here before you hollow it out. You have to be careful so you don't get it too thin because it'll chatter. You don't want that. You can either use the short side or the long side. This skewer doesn't make a lot of difference. Now let's see what that looks like. Not too bad. Okay. Now this is the part that's not a lot of fun. Your tool rest is good and tight. And this is where sound comes in, because you can tell when you're getting thin. Might want to check the depth. So you can go in here like this. We're not near deep enough. Oh, we can go another half an inch. This is getting a little thin here. You can tell by the sound of it. It starts sounding like a bell. Pretty good. Okay, now we'll come around. I'll put the lid back on so we can judge proportions. Wow. A little line in here I don't like, so let's take that. So let's take that out and take that little light in there. I don't like that. Just took that out. Now let's put the lid back on so we can get some kind of proportion. And what happens is the lid's fairly tight now, but it starts to shrink. You notice the lid runs perfect, but I don't do a lot of sanding. That's the object is you don't want to have to do a lot of sanding. You want to try to limit it. Thank you. the base a little bit smaller than the diameter, the largest diameter on the cup. There we go. Gonna be the end of it right here because we don't want a hole in the bottom. I'd like to get down there in there with a gouge, but you can't, so you're forced to scrape it with a round nose tool. You don't have a choice. How small you make it, well, just so it has good proportions. So it looks good. Down here, looks good, a little step in there. Sometimes I'll give it one of these. Okay, if you look at it close, it doesn't require a lot of sanding. It's kind of... And here's the beauty of this screw chuck system that I use. If I take it off and a week later I want to sand it. So a whole week went by and you say, oh, I forgot to sand that thing. So then you put it back on. And notice no chuck keys, no nothing. Put it back on, turn on the machine, and it runs just as true as when you made it. Okay.